Praise the Lord. Work, something that involves all of us. Whether you are a full-time church worker, or you're working in a marketplace, or you're a mother, a homemaker, we are all involved in work.
工作其实牵涉到每一个阶层，不管你是家庭主妇，不管你是全职人员，不管你是在哪一个领域，工作都牵涉到每一个人的方方面面。
All of us in whatever we do, actually what we want to do is we want to achieve some kind of success.
很多时候我们都要在追求一些成功。
When I was younger, I was sent to school. Then I went to university. Then I thought after university, you got to go out and find work so that you can have money. Then after you work, you have some experience and you become wise and you have success.
我从小的教育就是呢，我要上学，我要上课，然后呢，我甚至要上大学，然后找一份工作，然后工作之后我有经验之后呢，我就有这一个所谓的智慧。
I graduated from university in 1982, about over 41 years ago.
大概40多年前呢，我在1982年的时候呢，我在大学毕业了。
So that's all. I thought that's what I was going to do. I started working in banking industry.
我就开始在这个金融界、银行业在工作。
And I think I'm quite a hardworking person.
我觉得我是一个非常勤劳的工作者。
And within a year, I did very well. I made a lot of money.
在一年内，我赚了很多钱，我做得非常非常的成功。
But it didn't last very long. After 1 year, I lost it all and more.
但是却不长久，然后过一年之后呢，我损失了所有的金钱。
Between 1982 and 1995, I went on a roller coaster.Making money, losing money, making money, losing money.
从82年到1985年呢，我的生活像这个过山车，赚钱又亏钱，赚钱又亏钱。
So it was like 13 years of nightmare.
好像几乎有13年的这一个非常非常辛苦的日子。
So in desperation, I went to God. I went to the Bible. I asked God, I need help.I was desperate. My way was not working.
非常急迫的情况之下呢，我归向神，我读经祷告，然后我问神说，我需要你。
So in sharing this message, I would like to start with talking about two words, which I think we may be very familiar, but I'd like to go through it a little bit.
今天的分享当中呢，我要分享两个字啊，但是大家可能已经很熟悉了，但是我还要需要再深入的去分解。
One of them is called the word gospel, the other one is the word faith, and I believe all of us have heard it, used it, but there's a danger we become over familiar with it.
两个就是一个是福音，一个是信心，我们都已经很熟悉了，但有的时候我们太过于熟悉之后呢，反而我们会误解了这两个字。
I would like to share some words from Genesis chapter 2.
我想从这个创世纪的第二章来跟大家分析。
You know God created everything in 6 days, and on the 7th day He's rested. But Genesis chapter 2 is actually detailed record of what He did in day 6.
耶和华神呢创造宇宙万物那第六天他完全工作之后，然后呢，第七天他安息。但是在第六天的时候呢，他有一些特别的一些工作，然后我们要特别来注意。
Everything he did was good, but on day six he created man, and he said it was very good.
一切都创造得非常好。然后到第六天的时候呢，神创造的人，然后神说非常好。
In Genesis 2 verse 8,
yeah, 在创世纪第二章是这么样的。这样写着呢，第八节，耶和华在东方的伊甸栽了一个园子，把他所造的人放在那里。
I want you to picture, God created man, and then He put him in the garden. And what picture do you have? God was with Adam.
Okay, 我们要你看一个画面，神造了人。神也造了这个园子，然后神把这个人放在园子里面，这样的一个画面，你看到怎么样的一个画面
？Where was God after He created Adam, put him in the garden, and tell him to work the garden? God was with Adam 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
当神造了这个园子之后呢，把这个亚当放在这个园子里面之后，然后呢，神在哪里呢？神一直都与这个亚当同在。
I would like to suggest that is the gospel.
我要强调的，这就是福音。
There is a danger that we become overfamiliar with the word gospel. Sometimes we say, "Oh, have you heard the gospel? When was the last time you shared the gospel?" There is a danger. Our idea of the gospel is Jesus died for my sin, so that when I die, I can go to heaven. That is the gospel of salvation.
有的时候我们已经对福音很熟悉，很熟悉了。以致我们呢认为说，哦，福音就是呢，哦，耶稣为我钉死在十字架之后呢，等我死了之后我就到天堂去了，哦，但是这个福音其实呢就是这一个gospel of salvation， 也是一个救恩。
What's wrong with the gospel of salvation? There's nothing wrong. It is necessary, but it's only needed after you fall, after Adam fell and disobeyed God and fell.
福音是在当亚当背逆了神之后，然后呢，这个福音才这个才需要到福音，也就是说，之前神都一直与亚当同在的。
But the gospel is good news from a good God. God was a good God even before Adam fell.
福音是一个好消息，但福音呢是在亚当这个背逆之前这个福音这个好消息已经存在了。
So I want us to think of the gospel.In its original form, good news from a good God for His people.
啊，这个呢，就是要大家了解，就是呢，这个福音呢，就是从这个好神来的，就是给我们的这个好消息。
Okay, let's take a look at the next slide.
我们再看下一个。
After God put Adam in the garden, and God was with him, God said, "Adam, Genesis 2:15."
好，在这个《创世纪》第二章十五节呢，经上这样写：耶和华神把那人安置在伊甸园里，叫他耕种和看守那园子。
God say, "Work it and take care of it." The word "work" come from the original language of Hebrew. It says "agon." Agon means to manage or to steward.
在这个圣经里面，这个工作呢是从这个希伯来文里面 agon 来的。agon 这个意思呢，就是说要神要这个亚当呢去管理，还有掌管这个园子。
Notice that God did not give the title deed of the garden to Adam and tell Adam to go and build a condo and sell and buy and make money.
哎，好像你们都听得懂。OK， 啊，神没有叫亚当呢，就说哦，把它放在园子里面，然后就这样去盖大房子，然后呢叫你去卖，然后买又卖的这样子。
So God say, "Work it," and then in verse 16, He say, "Work it so that you may have food to eat." We work so that we can have food to eat.
神叫亚当说：“你工作，然后呢，你有食物可以供你。”
You know when Hokkien people meet, they say "Chapabe." Maybe Adam was Hokkien.
哦，福建人每次我们遇到人的时候，都会问很容易就问说：“哎，你吃饱了吗？”哦，他说可能这个亚当以前是福建人，叫爸爸。
And in verse 17 of chapter 2，
在创世纪的这个二章十七节呢，就这么写着：只是那知善恶树的果子你不可吃，因为你吃的时候你必要死。
If you eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, you will certainly die. When God says certainly die, means certainly die.Did Adam and the woman died after they disobeyed God?
神说，如果你吃那个分别善恶树的果子的话，你必要死。神说你必要死的话，你必要死。但是呢，亚当跟夏娃吃了之后，他有没有死呢？
They did not die physically. They died only after 900 years later. But they died immediately spiritually. They were separated from God.
他的这个肉身，他没有马上死掉 ，OK？ 但是呢，他的这个灵性，他的灵呢，已经死掉了，就已经跟神已经断除了。
They were no longer living in the gospel. God was with Adam. Adam disobeyed God. Now God is away from Adam. Because a holy God and a sinful Adam will die.
他已经已经没跟神已经没与他同在了，这福音已经离开了他了。那因为罪的关系呢，他们已经分离开来了。
So after the fall, Adam no longer can go to God 24/7. When Adam faced a problem, when God told Adam to name all the animal, when he has a problem, he just turned to God, and he just do whatever God tells him to do.
犯罪之后呢，亚当已经没有不能够这样子就直接找到神了。因为他在伊甸园的时候呢，当他在神要亚当去命名这些动物的时候呢，他不懂的时候，他能够去问神。但当他犯罪堕落之后呢，他已经不能够直接去找神了。
Work is God's idea. His design and his purpose is for us to have our character molded, for us to learn to manage responsibility, to bless us. Work was designed to be a joy.
工作原本是神设计工作原本是喜乐的，工作是要让我们在从工作当中去塑造我们的一个个性更像神。
How many of you today who are working, all of you are working, can say, "Wow, I enjoy my work so much. I look forward getting up in the morning to go and do my work."
这边还在工作的人，想问一下哦，多少人就是哦，我今天早上起来了，我很开心，我要去工作了，请举手。
It is designed that way. If it is missing, something is wrong. What I have learned, if something is wrong between me and God, it's never on His side, it's on my side.
Yeah, 原本我们应该有这样的一个感觉才对的，但是如果说没有的话呢，那就是有一些东西已经偏离了。已经错误了，那就是我跟神当中我们需要去理解的。
Why? So let's take a look at Genesis 3:17.
然后为什么会这样子呢？让我们来看创世纪三章十七节。三章十七节是这么写着：地就因你的缘故受咒诅，你必终身劳苦，才能从地里得吃的。
Notice that.The ground is cursed. Because the ground is cursed, work becomes painful toil.
因为地土受了咒诅之后呢，工作已经变成一种劳苦，一种非常非常苦的事情。
When my children were young, I would tell them, if you behave wrongly, I will punish you with a rattan. But I always separate the person and the behavior.When you misbehave, I'm angry with your behavior, but I still love the person.
当我孩子在小的时候呢，我会就是管教我的孩子啊，然后呢，我就当我孩子犯错的时候呢，我就会惩罚他们。但是我一般的惩罚就是呢，把这个他所犯错跟他这个人的人格把它分开。
When Adam disobeyed God, God was angry with his behavior, but God continued to love him.
当亚当这个犯罪的时候呢，神对他的罪是愤怒的，但是神仍然爱亚当。
God never cursed Adam, he cursed the ground.
神没有咒诅亚当，神咒诅的是那一个地土。
If you're experiencing difficulty in your work, in your family, in your health, because there is a curse, but it's not on you, it's on the ground.
当你在工作上、生活上遇到困难的时候，那里也许有咒诅，但这个咒诅并不是在你身上，而是在这个地图上。
You are not cursed, but you can reverse the curse on the ground for your life.
你并没有咒诅，但是呢，你能够把这个咒诅，把它这个在你的生命当中，把它翻转过来。
And it's available to you. Would you like to find out?
这个呢是能够让你得着的，你想知道吗
？Remember that God asked Moses to take the people of Israel out of Egypt.
记得这个神叫这个摩西把他的百姓从埃及引到这个应许之地。
Let's read what happened in Exodus 33.
让我们看出埃及第三章怎么讲，第十三节。现在我若在你眼前蒙恩，求你把你的道路指示我，使我可以认识你，可以在你眼前蒙恩，也求你想到这民族是你的人民。
Notice Moses asked God, "Teach me your way."
摩西求神说哈，啊，把你的道路来指示我。
The benefit of knowing God's way is in there. He says, "So that I may know you and continue to find favor with you."
啊，知道神的这个指示呢是非常非常重要的。然后呢，我们能够在当中能够大大的蒙恩。
If I ask Sister Shirley to show me, can you tell me how to get to Changi Airport?
如果说我问这个Shirley 姐妹怎么去这个Changi 机场
，She would probably give an instruction. You can drive from here, turn left, turn right, go north, and so on.
她可能会告诉她说，哦，你可以这样开车，然后转左转右，然后再继续走。
But here, God did not tell Moses.What to do, where to turn, but God said, "My presence is with you."
Amen. 啊，在这边神说，跟摩西没有告诉他说，哦，你要这样做，这样那样做，反而是什么呢？神跟他说呢，我与你同在
，and I will give you rest.
然后呢，我就会给你安息。这个在这个十四章十四节有这么讲到，耶和华说，我必亲自与你同去。也必给你安息。
Remember Genesis 2, verse 2? God finished all his work, he rested.
创世纪第二章呢，神完成了所有的工作之后呢，神就安息了。
He was with Adam. When Adam faced a challenge in naming all the animals, or what to do with the garden, all he need to do is turn to God, ask God what to do. And whatever God tells him to do, he just obey and do it.
神与亚当同在的时候，在园子的时候呢，当这个亚当去命名所有的动物、所有的这些的名字的时候呢，神都与这个亚当同在。而当亚当不明白、不懂的时候呢，他能够转向神，然后问神该怎么做。
The benefit of having God's presence is that we can go to Him anytime. That is called the gospel. But whatever God tells us to do, and when we obey it, is called faith.
好，当能够。我们能够转向神，问神该如何做的时候，能够转向神的时候呢，那就是一个福音。当我们能够按着神的旨意去做的时候呢，那个就是我们的信心。
So the gospel is God is with us. But as New Testament believers, you do not only have God with you, you have got God inside you.
Okay. 好，福音呢就是神与我们同在。但是呢，在这个新约的时候呢。神不只与我们同在，神在我们里面。
But we are not in the Garden of Eden anymore. We are in the New Testament. Then let's take a look what John 15:7-8 says.
那我们已经不再是在伊甸园里面了啊。那我们再看一下。那现在呢，我们来看一下约翰福音第十五章怎么写。好，第十五章七节是这样子：你们若住在我里面，我的rhema话也留在你们里面。无论你们想要什么。祈求就给你们成就。
If you remain in me, if you have God's presence with you, and you continue to run to Him, that is how you abide in Him.
当我们这个福音在我们身上的时候，我们不断的去追向神，追向神的时候呢，这个能力就在我们身上。
Take full permanent resident.
就对神就能够一直常住在我们里面。
And my word remain in you. Here it says rhema word, which is His voice, not the written word.
Rhema 这个是就是神所发出的话语。
So let me put it another way. You have the presence of God with you. If you remain with me, to meet with me, you keep on coming to me, ask me what to do. When I tell you what to do, you go and do it. That is the gospel, and obeying is faith.What is the result? Ask whatever you wish, and it will be given to you.
好，再强调就是，福音呢，就是当我不懂的时候，当我需要的时候呢，我转向神，然后寻求神的之后呢，我知道了之后呢，神所教我所做的事情呢，我去执行，我去做，这个就是信心啊。而这个呢，就是这一个神的话语这个 rhema 的意思。
When you do what God tells you to do, He will bring. The fruit of the Spirit in your life.
当神叫你做，你按照神的旨意做的时候呢，这个就能够结出果子。这个在我们的约翰福音十五章第八节有这样写到：这样，你们结出很多果子，我的父就因此得荣耀，你们也就是我的门徒了。
When you obey what the Holy Spirit tells you to do, the Holy Spirit produces fruits in your life. Fruit in your life.
当我们顺服着圣灵告诉我们的话语的时候，我们照着做的时候呢，我们生命当中就结出果子。
That will prove that you are His disciples.
这就能够像经里面所说呢，证明你我们是他的门徒了。
God's plan has always been to bless us, to nourish us, and to cherish us.
神的计划呢，就是永远就是要滋养我们也是要爱护我们的。
For many years, my life is a mess. I work in banking for many years. I'm very hardworking. In the outside, I look very successful.But on the inside, it was very empty. So I was making money, losing money. I make investment. And just before a crisis happened, and I can see all this because this all happened 30, 40 years ago.
在我的生命当中，以前我也是赚了很多钱，做了很多的这一个，我也非常非常勤劳的在这一个银行界里面工作，赚很多钱，然后亏很多钱，赚钱又亏钱。然后在当中，我们也经历了非常多的这些困难。
Even after I've become a believer, I've become a Christian, I hear a lot of good message that a good God wants to bless me.
甚至成为基督徒之后呢，我听到很多的这些教导，就是说神都要祝福我们的。
What are some of the blessings of God? Let's take a look at Deuteronomy 28. There list all the blessings. Here we have a few of them.
好，到底神对我们有怎么样的一些祝福呢？我们从《生命记》里面，我们几章我们来看。你在城里必蒙福，在田间也必蒙福。你出必蒙福，你入也必蒙福。那起来攻击你的仇敌，从一条路出来攻击你，必在你面前从七条路逃跑。你要借贷给许多国的民，却不会向人借贷。耶和华必使你做头不做尾，居上不居下。
There is more if you read in Deuteronomy 28:3-13. And I read it, and I read it, and I meditated it, I confess it. But it did not become a reality in my life.
Okay, 在这一个《生命记》28章到3节到13节，其实里面很多人都祝福。那 Ken 弟兄他就不断的去研读这些圣经，不断的这样子，不断的去冥想它，但是他却没有在他生命当中起作用。
Why?
为什么?
Isn't this the word of God?
难道这不是神的话语吗?
Shouldn't this be truth?
难道这不是真实的吗?
Well, we need to understand. I believe if anything is wrong between me and God, the fault is always on my side, never on His side.
我觉得就是说，当关乎到神跟与我当中有错误的话呢，错误的肯定是在我这一边，而不是在神那一边。
Sometimes we are too eager. We overemphasize the blessings.We forget what does He require for us to receive this blessing.
有时候我们太急迫了，我们却 emphasize,
we focus.
Yeah, 我们太注重于说到底经里面是要怎么去祝福我们的。
Remember, the gospel is God is with you. Faith is asking what to do.And do what he tells me to do. Present tense.
好，再一次的强调，就是福音呢，就是听到神告诉我们，然后信心呢，是我照着做。这个就是一个福音跟一个信心。
So I discovered the secret to have all these things available and manifest in your life.
所以我就发现到这个秘密了之后呢，我就把这个呢做在我的身上。
Go back and read.The first two verses in chapter 28 of Deuteronomy.
生命记里面呢，再回去鼓励大家回去读呢这一个二十八章的第一节跟第二节。好，第一节呢是讲说，如果你实在听从耶和华你的神的话，谨守遵行他一切的诫命，就是我今日吩咐你的，耶和华你的神必使你超过地上所有的民族。第二节。如果你听从耶和华你的神的话，以下一切的福气必临到你身上，必把你追上。
go to your own Bible, read it, meditate on it, and highlight if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord.
回去呢，就是把认真的把这个经文读了之后呢，甚至把它这个 highlight， 就是把它特别记录下来呢，然后呢，把它冥想进去你的整个生活当中。
Verse 2 say, these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, waiting for you if you obey the voice of the Lord.
你看这个第二节就是说啊，如果你听从耶和华你的神的话语，以下一切的福气必临到你身上，必把你追上。
Earlier this year, I shared a message called 听话 and I'd like you to listen to it again, meditate on it, go into your Bible and practice it, because that is everything.
好。今年 年初的时候呢 ，Brother Ken 弟兄他就有分享到这个讲道，就关于听话啊。那他鼓励大家呢多去听这个讲章，然后呢把这样的一个听话的这个讲章呢，把它就是冥想进去，生活在你的生活当中。
Now you can understand why when Jesus was challenged and asked.Of all the laws of God, which one is the most important? And Jesus said in John 12 and Mark 12:29.
当这个众人在挑战着这一个耶稣的时候，然后呢，耶稣呢就这么样讲，在这个马可福音第十二章第二十九节，耶稣回答说：“第一重要的是，以色列啊，你要听主我们神的神是独一的主。”
听话。It's most important. Jesus pointed out two trees in the garden. One you must not eat from. It's called the tree of knowledge of good and evil.
神就已经有一开始就跟亚当说，整个园子的水果你都可以吃，唯独这个分别善恶的果子的这个树呢，你不可以吃。
What is wrong with being knowing what is good?
那到底？知道什么是好跟坏，难道 有什么不对吗
？God want us to eat from the tree of life。
神要我们从生命树里面得着果子。
God is the tree of life。
神是这个生命树。
When He is available to us, we have access to the tree of life。
当神与我们同在的时候呢，我们就能够从这个生命树里面呢支取很多的生命。
If you do what the tree of life tells you to do, you will do what is right.
当你能够从这个生命树里面呢，这个做根据生命树的这一个支取这个力量的话呢，你所做的事情就会对的。
What is right is always good. What is good may or may not be right.
什么是对？做对的事都是好的，他做好的事呢，不永远都是对的。
That's our problem today. We are wanting to do what is good. We want to go into investment. We want to take this job. We want to become a missionary. We want to do things for God. All of that come from our human goodness.
我们常要做好的事情，我们可以去传福音，我们可以做这个传教士，我们可以去投资，但是很多时候呢，这些事情不一定都是对的。
God never created us.And then bless us and say, "Okay, bye bye. You go on your own."
神并没有说哈，神创造了我们之后，然后祝福了我们之后，就跟我们讲拜拜了。
His plan was to be with us all the time. We have access to Him all the time. But if you don't take advantage of it, you are just living from the tree of knowledge of good and evil.
神创造我们，他的计划是要常与我们同在。但是如果说我们没有与神这个与他这个同在的话，我们所支取的力量呢，都是从这个善恶树所结的果子当中得到的。
So that is half of my message today.
哦，这只是到一半而已。
Now,
shorten, not too fast.
Okay.
No, yeah, do not too long. Yeah.
The next one I want you to think about three words. What is called calling, call, gifts, and fruit.
下一个呢，我要跟大家分享的是关于呼召、恩赐跟果子。
How many of you here by show of hand know your calling？
多少人举起手？如果你知道你自身的呼召是什么，请举手。
Very good，
非常好。
Four， very good。
很多都知道哦。
I work in banking for 40 years.
我在银行业里面呢工作了40多年。
If you ask me in the past, I would tell you my calling is to be a banker.
如果你问在以前你问我的话呢，我会告诉你说我的呼召是在这个金融业里面。
Some people think their calling is to be a missionary, or to be an artist, or to be an engineer, or to be a lawyer.
有些人他会讲说，哦，我的呼召是成为engineer， 就是工程师啊，或者说是画家啊，或者说是不同的职业。
But I would like to tell you that all of us here has the same calling。
但是我要告诉大家呢，我们所有人这里呢都有一个相同的呼召。
Let's take a look at Mark 1:17。
那我们来从那个马可福音1:17这么写着，来跟从我，我要使你们成为得人的渔夫。
Jesus said, "Follow me."
耶稣说，跟从我。
That's your calling.
这就是你的呼召。
And then he said, "I will make you fishers of men."
那我就要让你成为得人的渔夫。
That is your gifting.
这就是你的恩赐。
The fact that I became a banker because I enjoy numbers, I enjoy meeting people, but that comes from giftings of God in my life.
我成为这一个在银行业里面工作呢，这一个是因为我这是我的恩赐。
If we're not careful, if we think to become fishers of men is what God wants me to do, I can go out and tell people about Jesus without following Him.
我们要很小心，就以为说，不要以为说我们的出去得人如得鱼，就表示说我们是在跟从他。
I'm sure you know the story about Peter walking on water.
我相信大家都听过这个彼得在海面上走行走。
What enabled Peter to walk on water?
什么能够让彼得能够走在水面上呢？
I was asking my son this just recently.
我这最近我就问我儿子一个问题。
And he told me because he fixed his eyes on Jesus.
我只说哈，因为他定睛仰望在耶稣身上。
You see, that is where sometimes when we read the Bible, we miss it. If Peter can walk on water just because he can fix his mind on Jesus, then Peter can continue to walk on water without following Jesus.
有时候我们读圣经有些误解。如果说彼得是定睛仰望在耶稣，然后能够走在水面上的话，他可能就是可以说只单单定睛，只在定睛在耶稣身上。
So I'd like you to go home and read Matthew 14 on this.
我要你回去读这个马可福音第Matthew 14 14节。
Peter say, "Lord, if it's you, tell me to come."
彼得就向耶稣说，耶稣若是你的话叫我过来。
And Jesus said, come.
耶稣说来。
So Peter could walk on water because he heard Jesus say, come.
彼得能够走在水面上是因为他听到耶稣说过来。
In your work, in whatever you do, you will find success when you understand the gospel and you understand faith is about doing what he tells you to do.
你在工作上你能够得到成功，是因为你能够听到福音，然后呢照着做，就是信心。
So I've been talking a lot about the blessing in the marketplace about money, 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 money. Some people have a problem with that because they say the blessings of God is not limited to money.
我们常在这个圣经里面看到很多的祝福，很多的祝福。但有些人讲说我们的祝福不单单只是金钱而已。
The blessings of God include protection.Include authority, anointing, and many other spiritual gifts.
福音呢，不只是单单只是金钱啊，祝福还包括身体啊，还有很多很多的不同的恩赐。
But of all the topics, single topics that Jesus talked about when he was here, it was about money.
但这么多的这耶稣所说的面，但是耶稣说非常多的呢，却关乎到金钱的。
Why?
为什么呢？
Let's take a look at Luke 16, verse 10 and 11.
好，那我们来看一下路加福音第十六章是怎么写。在最小的事上忠心，在大事上也忠心。在最小的事上不义，在大事上也不义。如果你们在不义的钱财上不忠心，谁还把真实的钱财托付给你们呢？
If you can be trusted with the little, you can be trusted with much.
当你能够在非常小的时候能够托付你的话呢，那你也能够托付你非常大的。
If you are trustworthy in the worldly wealth, which is money,
当你在托付在这一个金钱上面的时候
，you can be trusted with true riches.
那你就能够被托付到真正的富贵。
What is true riches?
什么是真正的富贵
？Can you imagine when whatever you say, you speak come true? When you lay hand on the sick, they get healed. When you tell a sick, a dead person to come back to life, they come to life.Those are true riches.
如果说你现在说你的口，你叫这一个生病的能够复原，甚至叫死人能够复活的话，这个就是这个口所说出来的，就是一个很强的一个富贵。
So the purpose of work is for God to enable God to build your character, for you to learn to mature, so that God can put true riches in your life, which is what we're all looking for.
Okay, can repeat this again in a small chapter, shorter verse.
The purpose of work,
在这一个我们的这一个工作的目的
is for God to build your character.
就是要塑造你的这个个性
for you to have maturity,
让你更加的成熟
to handle,
来处理
the blessings,
神给我们的祝福
starting with money.
从金钱方面
But he wants to put true riches on you.
他把这个真正的富贵放在你身上。
He wants to put his anointing on you.
他把恩膏放在你身上。
That whatever you speak come true.
当你所说出来都能够应许。
Whatever you see, you can bless other people.
当你看到的，你所看到，你都能够祝福其他人。
You are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
你就是这一个圣灵的这一个圣殿。
You are a steward of God.
你就是在这个以帮神在管理这地。
Being a steward of God only requires one thing. That is in 1 Corinthians 4, verse 2.
在管理这地呢，有要求一件事情，就是在这个哥林多四章二节，对于管家的要求就是要他忠心。
To be faithful. What is faith? To do what you hear.God tells you to do, 听话，
就是要听话，就是信心，就是要听话。
In Deuteronomy 8, verse 3,
在生命记第八章三节，它是怎么写着？使你知道人活着不是单靠食物，更要靠耶和华口里所出的一切话。
That we do not live on bread alone for physical food.We live for every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
我们人活着不是单靠食物，乃是靠着从神出来的每一句话。
And verse 18 says,
第十八节这么讲，你要纪念耶和华你的神，因为得财富的能力是他赐给你的，唯要坚定他向你的列祖起誓所立的约，像今天一样。
It is God.Who give us the power to create wealth?
是神给我们这个能力来创造财富的。
He wants to bless us.
他要祝福我们。
But if you do not know the requirement to be blessed, which is to hear His voice, you will be in working in toil and toil and toil.
如果你不知道这个神对我们的这一个要求怎么去那你就在工作当中呢，你就会面对非常多的这一个困难跟挑战。
Before I became a believer,
在我成为基督徒之前
people tell me about God. About God is good.
很多人告诉我说，这位神是非常好的神。
I used to ask, if God is so good, so powerful, how come there's so much war and killing in this world?
那你说，我也在问这个问题。当神这么好的话，为什么这世上有这么多的有战略，有这么多的这个征战呢？
I have come across some people, even believers, who have to work two jobs, three jobs just to make ends meet.
我也遇到一些甚至一些基督徒，他需要一个人打三份工作才能够维持这一个生计。为什么会这样子呢
？Sometimes non-believers seems to be doing better than believers.
有的时候好像非信徒还比这一个基督徒反而过得更好。
Why?
为什么会这样呢
？If you go to Psalm 73.You will see that non-believers will not end well either.
Yeah, 那你在这个
Psalm 73.
在诗篇第七十三篇，你看到
They will not end well either.
他们也不见得说他们也会过得很好。
But doesn't help my situation.
但是一点都对我们一点都没有帮助。
There is a scripture in Psalm 81, verse 13 and 14.
好，我们看这一个诗篇。只要我的子民听从我，以色列肯遵行我的道，我就迅速制服他们的仇敌，把手转回来攻击他们的敌人。
If my people would listen, come to God.
如果我的百姓能够听我的声音来归向我
，and follow my ways，
跟从我的方式
，that's faith。
这就是信心。
How quickly I will subdue their enemies？
那神就说呢，我就知道，我就会迅速的制服什么呢？他们的仇敌。
God is saying, come to me。
神说来到我这里。
You can hear me, my sheep can hear my voice。
你可以听到我的声音，我的羊会听到我的声音。
If you don't know how to hear it, that is what you need to be learning。
如果你不能够听到神的话语的话，那你需要学。
The little you hear,
你听到一点点
，you obey，
你遵行
；hear，
听
；obey，
遵行
；hear，
听
；obey，
遵行。
Very soon, your situation start to change。
很快的，你整个环境就开始改变了。
God say, how quickly I can turn your enemy away。
神说，我是能够迅速的制服你们的仇敌的。
We have a God who tell us the end。From the beginning，
我们有一位神已经告诉我们这一个结束，一开始就告诉我们的整个结束。
He tell us the future，
他告诉我们的未来。
Today，
今天。
We don't need to go to a fortune teller，
我们不需要去找这个算命的人。
Your work， become spiritual，
当你的工作是非常属灵的。
When you do what God。Tells you to do。
当你能够按着神教你怎么做的，你照着做。
So in summary，
好，我们来个总结。
Our last script， last slide。Work becomes spiritual。
当工作是这个成为属灵的，那在以赛亚书 ，Yeah， the last one， yeah。
This one。
Oh， okay。工作是属灵的。
But you need to check your understanding and application of the word gospel.
但是你要注意的就是你要注意就是呢什么是福音
，faith，
信心
，and what's the difference between calling and gifts.
还有就是呼召跟恩赐的不一样
，and make a little bit of adjustments.
然后做一点点的调整
，and you will realize.
你就会发现到
all his blessings are still waiting for you.
他所有的祝福都在等着你。
Jesus says there's an enemy who comes to steal and kill and destroy.
耶稣说哈，这仇敌就来偷窃、杀害跟毁坏。
But I have come.
但是我来。
To give you life.
我要给你生命。
Life abundantly.
是给你丰盛的生命。
It's still the truth.
这是一个真理来的。
I want to share one story before we end today.
我要跟大家分享一个故事。
Recently, I heard a story of this business person from South America.
我在我听过在从一个非洲的一个听到一个生意人
，He met a preacher at the airport。
他在这一个机场呢，就遇到一个传教士。
He said, "Sir, sir, do you remember me? You came to my church 36 years ago."
他说：“你还记得我吗？三十六年前你来过我们的教会。
”And the preacher said, "I don't really remember. Can you tell me the story?"
呀，那传教士说：“我不太记得，你可以告诉我吗
？”He said, "When you came."I was in so much trouble. My business was failing. All I had in my bank account is $1,000, and that was all the money I had.
他说当那时候你来的时候，我遇到你的时候呢，那时候我的生意是非常非常糟糕的。我在银行里面呢，只剩下1000块钱。
Well, in your meeting, I heard God say, "Give money."
但在这一个上一次这传教士在他们教会在传讲神的福音的时候呢，他就听到神说：“把你的1000块给出去。
”Give $1,000。
给1000块。
He said, "God, that's all I got."
他说：“神啊，这是我仅存的1000元啊。
”But later on during the book signing, he went to the table, he took one book, he gave away $1,000.
啊，当这一个传教士他们在就是他一个新书发布会哦，他就他签名的时候呢，他呢就把这1000块呢就给了出去。
36 years later，
36年后
，he met the same preacher，
他遇到同样的这一个传教士。
He said, "You know what happened the next day?"
你知道吗？第二天发生什么事呢
Somebody wrote me a check for $10,000.
有人给我一张支票，写了10,000元。
It's a business person who owed me money, who had such a bad reputation, there was no way he would pay me back.
哦，就是有一个生意人呢，欠了我的钱呢，实际上呢，他几乎不可能会归还我这钱的。
And today, my business is doing really, really well.
但是今天呢，我的生意已经做得非常非常大，非常非常的好。
No, with a testimony like that.There is an inclination for us to say, to hear the preacher say, "You see, if you take care of God's business, God will take care of your business."
在这样的一个见证当中，很多时候我们会听到一些牧者，他们会讲说：“哦，你只要照顾好神的工，神也会照顾好你的事业。”
Or you may hear the message say, "If you are faithful in sowing, you will reap."30, 60, even 100 times.
或者说呢，你只要愿意奉献的时候呢，你会得到很多倍的这一个祝福。
Remember, I asked you what caused Peter to walk on water?
他问你说，还记得是什么让彼得能够走在水面上
？What caused this businessman to prosper?
到底是什么样的使到这一个生意人他的生意突然间变得非常非常的好呢？
So when I read this testimony, I was surprised.
当我读到这样的一个见证的时候，我觉得惊讶。
And I discovered the reason he is now prospering is because he heard God and he obeyed.
但我就发现到呢，就是这个生意人呢，他能够听到神所说的，然后他顺服，也就是因为这样子呢，他就变成他的整个生意就非常非常的好。
I hope you've been blessed.
我希望你们都能够得到祝福。
God's principle hasn't changed.
神的原则从不改变。
He wants to bless you.
他要祝福你。
And he has told you how.
他也告诉你，神也告诉你如何。
I am with you.
我与你同在。
Whatever issue you have come to me.
你有任何的这些问题都能够来到我这里。
And whatever he says to you, do it.
当他神向你说话说呢，你照做。
It may not be what you want to hear,
可能不是你所愿意听到的
but obey it anyway.
但是顺服。
You may go to God and say, God, I need money.
你可能会去到神的面前说，神啊，我需要金钱。
But God tells you, you know that cousin of yours, I want you to forgive him.
可能神突然间告诉你说，你有一个这一个亲戚，我要你去原谅他。
Then you only do what God says to you.
你就按照神告诉你的，你照着做。
This is not a one-time thing, but it's a journey.
它不是一次过，它是一个长远的一个路程。
And this is not a lone ranger journey.
它绝对不是一个单独的一个路程。
That's why we need a community.
我们需要有一个属灵大家庭。
That's why we have a life group.
所以我们有这个小家。
That's why we have a local church.
我们有这样的一个教会。
So we can encourage each other.
我们能够互相的支持。
So we can.Correct each other.
我们能够互相的纠正
，so we can help each other.
我们能够帮助彼此
，to walk,
走在
as led by the Holy Spirit.
跟着圣灵的指引，走在神的道路上。
God bless you.
神祝福你。